we constitute the third largest domestic civil aviation market in the world. As an economy which is $2.89 trillion strong and which is transiting to becoming a $5 trillion economy by the year 2024, we are currently facing a penetration in civil aviation of as little as 7 to 8%. In spite of the turbulence in the sector, particularly characterized by the cessation of operation of one air carrier between December of 2018 and April of 2019, the sector has registered on a year-on-year basis for our November 2019 figures a growth of 11.03%.
We are now planning to reactivate some old airports, create some greenfield airports, and also establish a chain of heliports to connect the remotest parts of our state. It would help connect distant districts in Telangana such as Adilabad and also allow easy access to high footfall tourist destinations such as Yadadri. We would request the central government's funding support for creating the infrastructure and also request the Honorable Minister for expeditious approvals.
India is ranked amongst the best four countries in the world as far as airport connectivity is concerned. And we are looking forward to, if we have 100 operational airports now, we are looking forward to doubling the number of airports in the next 5 years. Not only this, this expansion and investment, if one really asks me a question, what has been the success story in PPP, I can straightway say, having worked in different sectors, that PPP in airport has been a real success story.
We are seeing higher growth, more than 25% to 30% year-on-year growth in tier 2 and tier 3 cities in the country compared to the overall growth. Around 1 lakh crores, that is approximately $14.5 billion of investment, is expected into this sector in the next 5 years. And out of this, Airports Authority plans to invest approximately 25,000 crores, almost 1/4 of the total investment, in the next 5 years for development, upgradation, and modernization of the various airports and the air navigation infrastructure in the country.
We have requested various regulators from various other countries to share their best global practices. Aircraft and engine manufacturers, we have a global CEO conference and global summit also there, ministerial plenary is there, and we expect that these discussions will have very meaningful outcome.